NASA, the National Aeronautics and Space Administration, presents Aeronautics and Space Report. This is not a television control room. It is, however, where astronauts training for upcoming Skylab missions are monitored as they practice going outside the Earth-orbiting space station to retrieve canisters of exposed film. The place is NASA's Marshall Space Flight Center, Huntsville, Alabama. Located here is a 75-foot diameter tank filled to a depth of 40 feet with 1.5 million gallons of water. It's called the Neutral Buoyancy Simulator. Placed inside the tank are full-size sections of the Skylab space station.
So that it's free enough to snap in and not have this part come down and hit the rail.
The workday begins at a briefing session before the astronauts go underwater. Many problems are discussed and worked out at this time. After donning their pressure suits, the astronauts prepare to dive. They are weighted with lead so that they neither sink nor float, but remain neutrally buoyant in the water, simulating weightlessness. This is astronaut Paul Weitz. He, along with Pete Conrad and Dr. Joe Kerwin, will be the first crew to man the Skylab space station next year.
Well, what we have to try to do is simulate the effects of weightlessness as best we can. On Earth, there are only two ways we can do it. That is by so-called neutral buoyancy, which is in a water tank, such as the one we have here, or by flying the weightlessness, the free fall parabolas in an airplane. The advantage of the neutral buoyancy tank is that you can work for extended periods of time in an environment that does simulate fairly faithfully, as has been evaluated by the people who've flown, the effects of weightlessness.
Skylab's three main objectives are: one, medical, to find out how well man can adapt to long-term spaceflight; two, to look at the sun above the Earth's distorting atmosphere and hopefully gain new knowledge about it for scientists; and three, look at the Earth itself. Earth resources, viewing everything from pollution to crop disease from a new perspective. Skylab underwater training, a valuable tool in preparing men for weightless space flight. Mars has for centuries challenged the imagination of scientists everywhere. Only in recent years has the faraway planet begun giving up a few of its well-kept secrets with the help of highly detailed photographs taken by the Mariner spacecraft. In 1976, the United States will land two unmanned spacecraft on the Martian surface. Called Vikings, the pair of landers will sample the atmosphere on the way down and then photograph and chemically analyze the surface. Experiments on board will also test for the presence or absence of life there. By comparing Mars with Earth, we should be able to understand better the origin and problems of our own planet. In New Mexico, some key tests were recently completed. Tested was the parachute landing system, which will carry the Vikings to a soft landing. After being lifted to an altitude of 120,000 feet, the spacecraft separated. Rocket motors ignited, boosting the vehicle to supersonic speed. At this point, the parachute was deployed. A protective shield blown away. And the chute lowered the simulated test spacecraft onto the desert. Successful testing of Viking, this country's first Martian lander.
This has been an Aeronautics and Space Report presented by NASA, the National Aeronautics and Space Administration.